Good afternoon, students. So, in unit on output costing, today we are going to discuss with the 17th question. Okay, once you see the question, in a factory, two types of articles are manufactured, number one and number two. From the following particulars, prepare a statement of cost showing total cost of each variety and ascertain the total profit. There is no opening or closing stock. So, here, actually in the question, what he has given, a company is preparing two types of articles. So, article's name is number 1 and number 2. So, here what he has given means there is no opening and no closing stock. So, material he has given, labor he has given. So, work on cost is charged at 40% of work cost. Very, very important point. Once you see that point, work on cost is charged at 40% of work cost and office on cost is taken at 20% on total cost. In the previous, I think so in the 9th, 10th questions, what we have seen there, work on cost is charged on labor, office on cost is charged on work cost, that we have seen. But in this question, what he has given, work on cost, nothing but factory overhead is charged on work cost, he has said. So here, one point you have to remember here, for prime cost, we have to add the factory overhead, then only we will be getting a work cost here. But without giving a work cost, what he has asked to calculate the factory overhead at rate of 40%. And same in case of office also. Office on cost is taken at 20% on total cost he has given. So number one articles sold during the period are 180 at 1200 each and number two articles are sold at 1500 each. So as per the exam point of view, very, very important method it is. So listen up. So materials 30,000, 50,000. Labor 60 and 70. So prime cost till here it is okay, same like previous sums. Now see the factory overhead. So factory overhead, what he has given in the question, 40% on work cost he has said. So how, where will get the work cost? This is called as a work cost, but on this he is saying the 40%. So here if work cost is, if factory expenses is 40%, then prime cost will be how much? 60%. Listen here, if work cost is 100%, factory expenses, he has said that it is a 40%, then prime cost will be a 60%. 60 plus 40 is nothing but 100%. In that way, you have to think same like profit I have explained in the previous question, in the same procedure. So, see here, factory expenses. Prime cost should be taken as 60%. For 60%, if it is a 90,000, then for 40%, it is how much? Okay, cross multiplication and you will be getting a 60,000. Same in case of number 2 also. Okay, here how much it is? Prime cost is 1,20,000. For 60,000, for 60%, if it is 1,20,000, means for 40%, it is how much? How much we got here? 80,000. Next, for prime cost, add this factory overhead and you will be getting a work cost. 1,50,000 and 2,00,000. Next, office overhead. Under office overhead, what he has given? 20%. What he has given in the question? 20% on total cost, he has said. Okay, here total cost is nothing but cost of production. Cost of production is 100%. On this, we have to calculate 20%. But we don't have here cost of production. We have only here work cost. Then what we have to think here, if office expense is 20%, then work cost will be 80%. Work cost will be 80%. In that way, we have to think. So, if for 80% it is 1,50,000, then for 20% it is how much? Once again, I will explain. Listen carefully. Here, office overhead, what he has given? 20% on work cost, he has said. So, 20% on total cost he has said. But here we don't have a total cost. Then how we have to calculate here? If office expenses 20% means work cost will be 80%. Why? Because work cost plus office, both we will be adding, then only we will be getting a total cost or cost of production. So in that way you have to think here. So for 80%, if it is 1,50,000, then for 20% how much? Cross multiplication, you will be getting a 37,500. Same in case of number 2 also. For 80%, if it is 2,00,000, then for 20% it is how much? 50,000. So work cost plus office overhead. Finally, you will be getting a cost of production. So in the question, what he has given? Sales he has given. Profit he has not given. Sales he has given. Once you see the question, here. Sales. Number one article sold during the period are 180 at 1200 each. 180 into 1200 you have to do. And number two articles are sold at 200 at 1500 each. 200 at 1500 each. So here what we have to do? 200 into 1500. So first we have to take the sales. Okay, so how much my sales here? 180 into 1200, 2,16,000. Next one is 200 into 1500, 3 lakhs. From these sales, you have to deduct the cost of production and finally you will be getting a profit. Okay, very, very important question, ma. Okay, if you are unable to understand, so once again, listen the video. Still, if suppose you have not understand, then you can WhatsApp me.